So for ease of use, the knife tool can be activated by pressing the K key while in edit mode. When you hover the mouse over edges, a preview for the starting point of the cut appears. Holding shift automatically selects the middle of every edge. By holding down the control key, snapping can be turned off. The first click sets the starting point of the cut. In Blender's knife tool, you have the option to click on the same edge again to select a different starting point without actually executing the cut. A right click finishes the cut and allows you to immediately start the next one on another position. By default, only visible faces are cut. To cut through the whole model, press C before your second click. The new vertices at the back are shown in a light green color. Cuts at the back are always made from the camera view. As soon as I click on an edge or polygon with a left click, I set the temporary cut, and the green cut points at the back turn red, and the cut lines become visible. We can turn this X-ray function off and on again with the shortcut V. You can decide for each cut with the shortcut C if you want to trim the back areas too. For straight cuts, you should either go to an orthogonal view or align the cuts with X, Y, or Z. To do this, set the first cut point, press X, Y, or Z. And as long as you don't press that axis again, you'll see this guideline with every further cut. As long as the cuts are not confirmed with space or enter, they are colored reddish, which means they are temporary. If I press escape, all temporary cuts are removed. I press the K key again for knife. The shortcut A allows setting the angle in 30 degree increments. When I see this white line, I enter, for example, 05 to set 5 degree steps, or 020 for 20 degree steps. If the line is yellow, the angle measurement starts from this edge. Pressing S displays the length and angle of the cut. Pressing S a second time will display only the length of the cut. Pressing S a third time will show only the angle of the cut. Pressing S once more turns off this display feature. As soon as you press return or space, all cuts are applied to the model. All the shortcuts for the knife tool can be found in the lower bar of the Blender interface, providing quick access to these features. You can start the tool from the toolbar, and you'll find the same options at the top. When occlude geometry is turned on, it prevents cutting through the back sides. This is the same as the cut through feature, which we can toggle on and off with the C key. If only selected is active, it cuts only the selected polygons, and with X-ray, we can see cuts that aren't visible, just like pressing V. Through the drop-down list, we can display lengths and angles. We can activate angle snapping based on the line or the viewport's view. Here, we can also directly input when the angle should always snap into place. You might think it's hard to remember all these shortcuts, but K, C, A, and Shift are the most important to start with. Here, they are briefly shown again. Pause the video if needed. The knife project function allows us to make a cut in a 3D object by applying the projection of a shape like a curve, text, or another geometry on it. This function is especially useful when we want to insert complex cut patterns or shapes into our models. We need a geometry that will get the cut and an object to serve as the knife, like a simple Bezier curve. First, we click on the object we want to trim, go into edit mode, select the cutting model from the outliner. The cut is made based on the viewport view. Therefore, it's often wise to switch to an orthogonal view to avoid distortions. Then access the knife project function by looking for it in the mesh menu while you are in edit mode. If we choose the cut through option from the options, the projection will go through the whole model. Geometry without a boundary will not work for the cut because it lacks a boundary. However, if you remove a face from this object, a boundary is created, which can then be used for the cut. To view the boundaries of an object, you can switch to Edge or Vertex mode. Then, under Select, choose the Select All by Trait option, and there Non-Manifold. Make sure the Boundaries option is selected to make the boundaries relevant for the cut visible. With the Bisect tools, you make a flat cut across the entire model. In the Edit mode, I press A and select everything. In the Mesh menu, I select Bisect. Now I define a cutting line in the viewport. For perfect straight cuts, it's better to do this from the orthogonal view. Depending on where we started the cut, a tool with a yellow arrow appears, which we can use to move the position, or a turquoise circle to rotate our cut. In the option box, we can also change the position with numbers. Using Clear Outer will hide the geometry starting from the arrow, and Clear Inner will hide the rest of the geometry. If we activate both, it shows the cross section as an edge. When we turn on Fill, it automatically closes the boundary. We can adjust the precision of the cut with the axis threshold. The smaller the value, the more accurately it adheres to the original geometry. We also find the tool in edge mode in the menu with the right mouse click, and also in the tool palette directly below the knife tool. Here at the top, we now also find the same options again. Let's look at another way to further cut a mesh. With loop cut and slide, we add extra divisions along loops, which are circular lines around the mesh, and can slide them, meaning move them up or down the loop. We switch to edit mode with edge selection, right click and select loop cut and slide, or we do it from the edge menu, or simply press Ctrl and R. Now you can set the number of cuts by scrolling the mouse wheel or using page up or page down. With a left mouse click, confirm the number of cuts, and then you can set their position with the mouse or with the right or left keys on the keyboard. After confirming with a left click, we can still adjust some settings in the option box. We can also set the number of cuts later and move them in one direction or another with the factor. Let's go to a very simple house model. When I insert a loop cut with Ctrl plus R here, it creates a cut in the middle. Pulling on the factor slider moves the new edge to match either the roof or the floor. Activating even focuses this one edge on a specific side, either the floor, and when I press flipped, the edge focuses on the roof. If I increase the number of cuts now, each edge loop will focus on the selected edge. From the top towards the floor, or if I press flipped, from the floor towards the roof. And when I deactivate even, the loops spread evenly in both directions. With smoothness, we can add a curve based on the falloff. Outwards or inwards. Let's look at a simple flat surface to get how smoothing works. If I cut the middle of this surface and turn up the smoothing, nothing changes because there are no bends anywhere else. But if I lift the right side and try again, I can make the cut fit in a way that creates a nice bend. Now I'll do the same on the other side, but in the opposite direction. When I make two cuts in the middle next, one side goes down and one goes up, making a nice overall curve. Now let's apply our new knowledge to Suzanne. Here too I add a few cuts. Without even, the edges adapt to their respective edge loop. When I click even, the edges align more with a specific edge loop. In this case, the lower edge loop. It fits at the bottom, but not quite at the top. With flipped, we reverse the whole thing. Now it fits perfectly at the top, but not at the bottom. Let's take a look at Suzanne from the side. Without smoothness, the surface is simply divided further. With smoothness, we make our shapes rounder like we saw with the flat surface. As we've observed, when even is enabled, the edge loops fit perfectly on one side, and with flipped, they fit perfectly on the opposite side. Depending on the geometry, we can choose which outer edge should have more precise edge loops, or you can turn off even. Of course, I need to reset the factor to zero. Now, it tries to spread the edge loops uniformly, but depending on the shape, this doesn't always end up just right. With the offset edge slide command, we can add an extra subdivision to each side of an edge loop. We select an edge loop, right-click, and access the offset edge slide command. Using the mouse, we determine the distance to the original edge. When I confirm with a left click, I can adjust the settings afterwards. With factor, we adjust the distance again. When even is turned off, we notice that the distances to the original edge aren't perfect. By activating even, I can choose whether the new edges align exactly to one side or the other. New is cap endpoint, which connects an edge, not part of a complete loop, to the original loop at the endpoint. Finally, let's look at how we can create a cut between two or more edges without using the knife tool. First, we select the edges that should be cut, right-click and choose the Subdivide tool. This easily adds an extra edge between them. As mentioned, this works smoothly with multiple edges as well. In the options, we can also set more subdivisions. In this tool, there are more settings possible, but I believe that's enough for now in this video. If you enjoyed the video and wish to see more content like this, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Now check out Bevel Like a Devil and Extrude in Blender to learn more about Blender's tools. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day.